Hi guys, my name is Ashish Bhandari and welcome to our brand new show, The Travel Commanders in Chief. Here we are in conversation with Mr. Luis Cabello, the Trade Counsellor of Peru in India. Hi Mr.
Hi.
Luis.
Nice to meet you.
Tell us about how important is India as a source market for Peru?
The Trade Office of Peru in India started working in 2014.
Okay.
Initially, we did what we have to do through our embassy, but the embassy decided to open an office like what we are handling now.
Okay.
And the thing is that after that, a lot of people start knowing about Peru.
Okay.
Sometimes when I met some people from India and I asked a simple question, do you know what is Peru? Yeah, it's a guava.
Yeah.
No, wait a minute, guava in Karnataka, but not everywhere. And also they don't really know where Peru was located, for example.
Okay.
We start talking about Peru, teaching people, do a lot of training sessions, seminars, and now the things are good for both of us.
All right.
We are growing in the last 3 years an average of 20%.
Okay.
We expect some good numbers also this and for this 2019.
In terms of number, what kind of numbers are we currently looking at?
I expect that this year we will have 15,000 Indian travelers going to Peru, visiting Peru. And you know, when you are traveling to such particular market, such particular destination,
yeah,
that is in the other side of the world, the people invest a good amount of money.
Okay.
We are not looking for millions of Indian traveling. That will be amazing for us. But right now, the number of travelers that are visiting Peru are really investing the money that we expect to receive from these people, no?
Okay.
And they come back fascinated about my country.
And so what kind of experiences do Indian travelers expect when they go to Peru?
I will mention it in only one slogan. That is our slogan in the last 2 years. Peru is the richest country in the world.
Right.
Why?
Yeah.
Because we have everything for everybody.
Okay.
If you are looking for adventure, you got it in Peru. If you are looking for, trekking, we have the Andes Mountains, amazing place to visit. If you look for sports, the Pan American Games, what happened in Peru last year.
Yeah.
Culture, as well as India, we have more than 5,000 years of civilization. The origin of the civilization in South America belongs to Peru. And if you talk about gastronomy also, my God, Peru in the last 8 years, 8 years in a row,
yeah,
according to the World Travel Awards, is our world's best culinary destination.
Wow.
So if you want to eat good food, you have to go to Peru. One thing that I'm not sure that maybe you don't know, the origin of potato belongs to Peru. We have more than 4,000 varieties of potatoes. Yeah, so remember that every time that you eat a samosa. Because that samosa has part of the legacy that we gave to the world,
okay,
our potatoes.
You know, there's a report from UNTO that in 2020, there'll be around 50 million people who will be traveling outside India.
Maybe more.
And probably more. And out of that, 40% are millennials.
Yes.
Who are traveling. How important are millennial travelers for Peru?
As I mentioned, because these are the new millionaires in India.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
not only because of money, because they are expecting something different. They want to they want to have new experiences.
Yes.
And that is what we are offering.
Yeah.
You can go have the normal visit to one city. Plus, I'm sure that one company will give you another experience. Okay,
exactly.
You will visit one family and you will cook with them. Or maybe you can stay with this family.
Okay.
That is a new experience. Oh, okay, forget about this traditional tour. We're going to give you this kind of tour.
Okay.
Because we know what you are expecting from this particular destination.
Okay.
That is why the group of companies that are dealing with Indian companies are those that can customize,
yeah,
their packages, their services, their itineraries.
Millennial travelers are somebody who consume a lot of content online, and then they also book online.
Yes.
So do you have any marketing strategy in place in your scheme of tax scheme that you would want to invest in online marketing for Peru?
Yes, we are part of the Peruvian government. We are the trade office here in India. Yes. And because of that, we have a strategy not for only for India, but we have a worldwide strategy, okay, especially for that particular market. We are doing a lot of media, social media activities.
Okay.
Especially we have our page in Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, okay, plus our own website.
Okay.
Attach Peru in India and you will find all the information about Peru.
Okay.
And we are always uploading a lot of details, a lot of information, photographs plus videos,
okay,
about my country and what these people could get from my country. And I'm sure that they will find everything visiting only Peru in India.
We had a great insight from Mr. Luis for the destination Peru. And I'm sure people would love to visit the destination.
Don't only watch this interview, just visit Peru. Go to Peru. I'm sure that you will come back and you will talk about my country. Sure of that.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.